हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड इवनिंग। हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर वेरी गुड। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सिक्स स्टैंडर्ड ज्योग्राफी चैप्टर 3। सो दैट इज द कंपेयरिंग ए ग्लोब एंड ए मैप फील्ड विजिट्स। सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द ग्लोब एंड मैप। Okay, so how it is useful for the field visit. So, and the comparisons of a globe and map. Okay, so globe means already we know, so that is the model of the earth. Okay, and map also we know, we have the different types of maps, like district map also, state maps also, India physical map also, political maps map also, world map also. So these all are what? Map. Okay, so what are the uses of globe and what are the uses of map? Let us see. Friends, we have seen how meridians and parallels are drawn on a globe. We have also learned how they are used to determine the location. So in the last chapter, we already learned what are the meridians, what are the parallels on the globe, and how it is used for determining the location. So that all things we all learned. So meridians we call as a longitudes or vertical lines, and parallel lines we call as a latitudes, or it is also called as a horizontal lines. Okay, and using, when you want to find any location of a particular area, so you have to use the one vertical line as well as one parallel line. So that is a one meridian and one parallel you have to use for finding the location. But when you want to find the any extent of area, that means length and width of any particular state or country, so you have to use the two parallel lines and two vertical lines. So these all things we'll learn in already second chapter. In this lesson, let us compare a map and a globe and understanding the difference between them. Okay, so in this chapter, we are going to discuss about the what are the similarities between map and globe and what are the differences between map and globe. So let us see. So this is the world map, and here they are showing the continents. So already I told you 7 continents we have. So that is the Asia, Africa, Europe, South America, North America, Australia, Antarctica. Okay, these all are what? Continents. And we have the 5 oceans also, that is the Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Southern Ocean, Indian Ocean, and next one is what? Next one, Arctic Ocean. Okay, so these are the 5 oceans. So this is the world map. So our country is located in which continent? Asia continent. See here, so this is the India. So India is located in which continent? Asia continent. So which map this is? So here all continents are available, all oceans also available. So that means what? Which continent this is? Which map this is? World map. And here, see here, here they are given the symbol also. So N means what? It is north side, and down part we have the south side, and this is the east side, and this is the west side. So like that we have to take the directions also. Next one, see here. So this is the India map. This is what? India map. And this is what? Globe. So already you know. So this is India map and this is the globe. Okay. So first one, A picture shows the world map. B picture shows the outline map of India. And C picture shows the globe. Make a group of 5 or 6. Each group should have world map, a map of India and globe. Study them and answer the following questions. So here they're asking the questions, which device is flat? Okay, which device is flat? See here, so in these 3, which device is flat? Which device is flat? So these, here we have the 2 types of maps, and here we have the globe. Which one is the flat? So map is the flat. So what is the answer? Map. And which device is spherical? So already we know, so earth is in a spherical shape, so globe also in a spherical shape. So which device is in spherical shape? Globe. And third question, which of these devices allows you to see the entire area of the earth at the same time? Okay, using which device you can see entire world? Okay, which device we can use for seeing the entire world? Suppose you are seeing this map. Okay, so you can see backside of the continents also? Not possible. Suppose you are seeing this India map. Okay, so you can we can see all the areas front and back at a time? No, not possible. But when we are seeing the globe, so we can get all information throughout the world. at the same time. Which device allows you to see only one side of the earth at a time? So which device we can see you using one side of the earth? So this map, that means not a India map we can use for getting the information about one side of the earth. So only one side we want to know, so that for that we have to use the map only. So this one is map. This answer is what? Map. And next one, which device can be used for studying a particular region in detail? So suppose you want to know about the particular region. Suppose you want to know about India only. So which device you are using? Map. So India, simply you are taking India map, you can understand everything. So this one is what? Map. And which device can be called as model of the earth? So already I told you, which device we are using for the model of the earth? So that is globe. Very good. Next one, explanation. You must have observed that maps are two-dimensional, whereas globe is three-dimensional. You must have observed that maps are two-dimensional, whereas globe is three-dimensional. That means, see here, so maps are two-dimensional only. That means it has the length and it has the width, two only. There is no height. But here coming to the globe, so it has the length also, it has a width also, it has the height also. So it having two-dimensional, it is having the, it's a three-dimensional. So map is two-dimensional and globe is three-dimensional. Two-dimensional objects have length and width. The product of length and width defines area. So what are the two-dimensional objects having? So that all are having the length and width only. So when we are multiplying the length and width, we will get the area. So that means what? See here. Suppose this is the length. So 2 meters, and this is the width, it is 2 meters. So 2 into 2, how much? 4. So what is the total area of this map? So 4 meters. Okay, it's 4 meters square. So that is the area of this total area of this map. Okay, next one. Three-dimensional objects have length, width and height. The product of these provides volume. Okay, so three-dimensional having the length, width as well as height also. When we are multiplying length, width, height, so we will get the volume of that particular object. So next one, map can use it to study the whole world or also region of limited extended. Okay, when we are using the map, so we can study the whole world or also region of the limited. So when we are using the world map, we can see the world, as well as when we are using the India map or any district map, we can see that particular area of that district or particular state or particular country only. So map we can use like that. However, small or large the globe, it is only a representative model of the entire earth. So we have the different sizes of globes. Okay, so some globes are in big size, some globes are in very small size, but every globe showing the model of the earth only. How earth having the continents and oceans, so this globe also having the all oceans and continents, and what are the landforms, water bodies having on the earth, so that all will be show on the globe. So whether it is a small size or whether it is a big size. So here they are giving some examples of the two-dimensional objects. So paper also, blackboard also, table also, tabletop also, land also, these all are two-dimensional areas. So what are the three-dimensional areas? An object having the three-dimensional, such as length, width, height, is called three-dimensional. Example, duster, box, glass, pot, hill, the moon, etc. These all are what? Three-dimensional. That means these objects are having the height, length, width. Okay, next one. Field visit, educational trip. A field visit is an important method of studying geography. Field visits help us to understanding the geographical and social conditions of a place. Moreover, it provides an opportunity to directly interact with the local people and understanding their problems. Okay, so field visit means what? Educational trip. So educational trip is very important. Why it is important? When we are seeing any new place, so we have the curiosity about that particular place. So for that, you are interacting with the local people who are living in that places. So you are talking with that people and you are getting the information. So when you are getting information, you can understand which type of geographical conditions are there, which type of climate is there, which type of social conditions are there. So these all things we can understand using that field visit. So that's why field visit very important. Next one, see here, geography museum. Earth is the largest operational globe in the world. It is housed at Armouth in the state of Maine in the United States of America. The rotation and revolution speed of this globe is maintained as the per that of the Earth. Okay, so in America, United States of America, having the one museum. Okay, so that museum name is Geography Museum. So here one big Earth was there. One big Earth is there. Okay, so that Earth, how actually Earth rotated, same like how which speed Earth rotating, same speed this Earth also rotating. That means simply it is look like as a Earth, and how Earth is rotating in that speed only it is rotating. So this museum is in where? America. So this is the third chapter. I hope you all are understand this chapter. If you like my teaching, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.